What's up internet, welcome back once again. I am Manish from rebellionwriter.com. As promised, in today's tutorial we will learn how to write a dynamic SQL using execute immediate statement. So without wasting much of your time, let's start the tutorial. So before we start writing an example, let's first quickly see what is an execute immediate statement in Oracle database. Using execute immediate, we can parse and execute any SQL statement or a PLSQL block dynamically in Oracle database. Execute immediate is best suited for those SQL statements which return a single row of results. If your statement returns more than one row of results, then there are other ways which we will discuss in future videos. Let's quickly take a look at the syntax of execute immediate statement. Syntax starts with the result phrase execute immediate. Followed by that, we have to write our query. This query could be a SQL statement or a PLSQL block. Compiler treats the dynamic query as a string of varchar 2 data type. Thus, you have to make sure that you enclosed your query into a pair of single quotes. We will learn how to write a dynamic query properly for execute immediate when we will do the example. Then we have an into clause. Using this clause, we specify the list of the user-defined variables which will hold the values returned by dynamic select statement. It is very similar to the select into statement. Also, it is an optional clause. If you don't require it, then you can omit it. Next, we have the using clause. In case you have used a bind variable in your dynamic query, then this clause will enable you to specify the values for the bind variable which will get substituted during the runtime accordingly. Also, this is again an optional clause. Then we have the returning or return into clause. It is sort of opposite to the using clause, where in using clause we are supplying the value to the dynamic query. Here in returning into clause, we get the values returned by the dynamic query and store them into the specified list of bind arguments. That sums up our syntax. Before moving ahead, I want to ask you guys to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends, because your every single like and share keeps me motivated to produce more such videos. Thanks. Now, let's quickly do an example. In this example, we will see how to write a DML select statement using execute immediate with into clause in Oracle database. Like always, I will try to keep the example as easy and simple as possible so that we can understand how to write an execute immediate statement properly. Let's do it. Here is the declaration section of our PLSQL block. In this section, we have declared two variables. The first variable is SQL underscore QRY of varchar 2 type. We will use this variable to store the select statement which we want to execute with our execute immediate statement. As this variable is going to hold a DML statement, thus we have to make sure that it's got a sufficient data width. In my case, I have assigned 150. It should be enough. If it is not, then we will change it later on. After that, we have another user-defined variable emp_tot. We will be using this variable with into clause to hold the data returned by our select statement. Now, let's write the execution section. Here is our execution section. As you can see, we only have three statements inside this section. Let's see what are these. Statement 1. In the first statement, we are assigning a valid SQL query to the variable SQL underscore QRY. The query which we are assigning to the variable SQL underscore QRY is a select statement which is returning the total number of rows of the employees table. There are few precautions which we have to take while writing the query for dynamic SQL processing. We will discuss them in a bit, but first let's see what is the next statement. Statement 2. The second statement is the execute immediate into statement. If you take a look at this statement, then you will see that right after writing the result phrase execute immediate, we write the name of the variable SQL underscore QRY, the same variable into which we stored the select statement. On execution, the runtime engine will replace this variable with the content it is holding, which in our case is a select statement. If there is no error, then the runtime engine will execute the underlying select statement and return its result if there is any. Our select statement is returning a value which is the total number of rows of employees table. Using into clause of execute immediate statement, we are storing that returning value into the variable emp underscore tot. If you want, you can skip the first statement completely just by writing the SQL query directly after the result phrase execute immediate like this. But I like the former way of coding because it makes your code look neat and clean as well as helps you in keeping a track on your query if in case you ever want to change or modify it. Anyways, statement 3. The third statement is an output statement using which we are displaying the value of the emp underscore tot variable back to the user. Now let's execute this program and see what the output is. Here is our output. Now let's come to the precaution part which I mentioned earlier. There are two very small things which we have to take care of while writing a SQL query for execute immediate statement. First, enclose the query into single quotes. Execute immediate treats the SQL query as a string of varchar 2 data type. Thus, it becomes mandatory for us to enclose the query inside the single quotes. Second, no semicolons. Usually, when we write a SQL query, we terminate it with a semicolon. But in case of execute immediate, whenever you will be writing a query, you have to remember that you do not terminate your query with a semicolon inside the single quotes. On your screen, you can see an example. Here I am showing you the wrong way of writing a query for execute immediate statement. As you can see, here we put the semicolon inside the single quotes with the query as well as outside the quotes to end the statement. Here the first semicolon which is inside the single quotes is wrong, but the second semicolon which is right outside the single quotes is perfectly fine. Now, let me show you the correct way of writing this same query. Here we are. As you can see, this time there is only one semicolon which is outside the single quotes and none inside the quotes. You can head over to my blog to learn the proper way of writing SQL query directly into your execute immediate statement. Link is in the description. Let's call it for the day. This is the tutorial on execute immediate with into clause in Oracle database. Hope you enjoyed watching and learned something new. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Also, share it with your friends. Most importantly, subscribe, as in the next tutorial, we will be playing with the bind variables with execute immediate statements. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.